Shopping for my first RV, should I get new or should I buy used? I'm going to share the answer with you right now. Hey there, how are you? Welcome back. I'm Dr. Dave, the RV dummy. I really appreciate you. If you're brand new to me, give me a subscribe and give me a like. Anybody watching, any of you, whether you subscribe or not, give me a like right now. You're going to love this video. Here's the reason why. I got a great question as a comment on my channel for one of the other videos I did recently. It was from a guy named Greg Martin, and I'm going to read his question. I promised him that I said to him, it's such a good question. I'm going to do a show and answer it right on the show. So Greg's question is, I'm shopping for my first RV. I was planning to get one that is lightly used to avoid some depreciation, but there are some safety and functionality improvements that can't be added on an older rig. 360 degree view, lane keep, collision avoidance can't easily be added. Now I'm torn. What should I do? What's your advice? Signed, Greg Martin. Greg, it's a great question. I'm gonna, before I answer your question directly, I'm gonna give you a quick analogy. I'm not gonna talk to you about my rig. We've got, as you probably know, we've got a Class B RV. It's a pleasure way. It's a 2007. I always get this wrong, because it's a 2006 build. But it's 2007 Pleasureway. That's great. But let's not talk about our RV for a second. Let's talk about our car. We have one of our cars is a 2005 Volvo XC90. It's approaching 150,000 miles. We love the car. We've kept it. We bought it new back in 2005. Kept it in great condition. It's comfortable. It just does exactly what we want. But we're here in Utah, and in the winter can get, you know, pretty nasty sometimes with a lot of snow. And Yoko and I were talking about a month or two ago about when should we get a new car and replace this one? And because the new cars have all the, you know, the safety features, the functionality, the lane change, beeping this, beeping that, or, you know, all the great stuff. And we were talking pretty seriously about it, because of course it would be safer, it would be comfortable to drive. But then as we thought about it, you know, let's just say we'd have to drop $40,000, I'm just making the number up, $40,000 on a new car. That's probably about the range, maybe even a little more, that's probably about the range if we got a new car that we would probably pay somewhere around there. Maybe even a little bit more. Is having that functionality, the new safety features. Yeah, I would love it when, you know, when I'm like a little light goes off when I'm like crossing over the lane and something starts beeping and tells me I'm you know, hey, get back in the lane. All these, I like that. But when we sat down and said, are those safety features, the functionality, are they worth $40,000, $45,000, $50,000? And our answer was no. We'll keep driving what we're driving. It's a good, safe car. It's definitely safe. It just doesn't have the brand new safety features. But it's a pretty darn safe car. So I'm gonna have to use the mirror a little bit more diligently. Okay, I put a backup camera in, so it is okay. Same thing goes with RVs. First of all, Greg, I love your question, but I know nothing about your finances. It comes down to what you can afford. Now, if you are a multimillionaire and, you know, throwing, I don't know, $100,000, $150,000 down on an RV, if it won't make a dent in your nest egg, if it won't hurt your retirement at all, and if that's what you want, then yeah, then go for it. If you can totally afford it, and again, it won't change anything in your life. Yes, but if you don't have that type of income, or don't have that type of tremendous savings, if you're not a multimillionaire, if it's gonna definitely make a dent or hurt your savings a little bit, I would say don't do it. Drive. Look, I can make the argument right now that every year there's going to be some kind of new feature on a car or on an RV that is better than last year's. I think nobody would disagree with that. Things get better and more technologically advanced every year. So suppose you buy a brand new one now, and then 2 years from now, some amazing, amazing safety feature comes out. Are you going to just get rid of what you have now? No, you're probably not. So my feeling is It depends what you can afford, number one, without having to take a loan out. Remember, this is the RV dummy, and we, on this channel, we don't believe in taking loans out for depreciating assets. We believe in paying cash only what you can afford. So great, it comes down to what you can afford. I say there's nothing wrong with buying a rig that is a few years old, that's got some, it's already been depreciated somewhat. The owner took excellent care of it. It's in great shape. I say there's nothing wrong with that. Spend a little extra money and buy some incredibly large side mirrors. Spend $1,000 on a set of mirrors and you'll still come out, you'll come out way ahead, way ahead. As I said, we've got a 2007 Pleasure Way. It's built on a 2006 Ford E350. Obviously, 2006, they didn't have nearly the safety features they have right now. Am I going to sell that and get a new one just because it's got better safety features and maybe more comfortable in certain ways? No, I'm not going to do that. It's not worth it. I can afford to do it, but I'm still not doing it. That's my answer. Hope it helps you, Greg. Be safe out there. Buy what you can afford. Don't go overboard. That was a rhyme. That was not intentional. I'm Dr. Dave, the RV dummy. Hope that helped not only Greg, but I hope it helped any of you in your lives, whether you're looking for an RV, a car, anything. I hope that helps. I'll talk to you on the next video. See you soon. Bye.